Dear students, let's now discuss about center of mass. When we just talk about center of mass, we can simply state that it is a point associated with a system of particles where you can say all the masses of system are supposed to be concentrated. This is a point where we consider all the mass of the system is supposed to be concentrated. We can also state when we talk about uniform bodies, we can state for uniform bodies, we can state center of mass is located at geometric center of bodies. And here, even if more than one body or two bodies are there, we can use the concept. Like, say we are having two identical bodies, both are of mass m, and say both are point masses. Say these are separated by a distance l. In this situation, due to symmetry, we can state the geometric center is at the midpoint, so the center of mass of this system is located at the midpoint of the two objects. Similarly, say we are having an equilateral triangle, and at each of the vertices of an equilateral triangle, identical masses m are placed. So again, by symmetry, we can state the center of mass will be located at the centroid of this triangle. So its center of mass will be at the centroid. If we talk about a uniformly dense object like a sphere, if a sphere is uniformly dense, so due to symmetry, we can state uniformly dense object, its center of mass will be located at the center of the sphere. Similarly, if we talk about a right circular cylinder like this, so if the cylinder is of height h, say altitude of the cylinder is h, and if it is uniformly dense, we can state that center of mass will be located at a height h by 2, which is the geometric center of the object. So students, let's talk about types of system of particles. Very first thing you must be aware about that every physical system in nature can be termed as a system of particle. Because earlier I hope all of you might have studied that everything in nature is composed of group of particles or atoms or molecules. So we can say that every physical system in nature is a system of particle. And now we can state that based on relative location of particles in a system, system of particles can be classified in two categories. These categories are, the very first is discrete object system, and the second is continuous object system. Let's discuss both of these, discrete as well as continuous object system, in detail. Let's first talk about discrete object system. In a system of particle, when our objects are independent, then the system is termed as discrete object system. We can state discrete object system are basically system of particle with several independent objects. Independent or isolated objects are there in a discrete object system. Like for example, say we are having a system of two masses m1 and m2, and here it is given that m2 is more than m1. That means the second mass is heavier. So, just by observation, we can state that the central mass of the system will be located somehow near to M2. This is the central mass of the system. However, we have already studied that if the two masses were equal, in that situation, by symmetry, the central mass would be located exactly midway between them. Now, say if we talk about a system of three particles, say these are M1, M2 and M3. As I have drawn with the sizes, we can simply see that M3 is heavier than M2 and M2 is heavier than M1. Now, if we want to locate the central mass of the system of these three particles, first let us ignore this M3. We talk about M1 and M2. By observation, we can state that the central mass of this system would be located somewhere near to M2 because it is heavier. Or this is the point where we can assume that the mass M1 plus M2 is concentrated. Now, if we keep M3 in picture, then the central mass of this M1 plus M2 and M3 will be located somewhere on the line joining M3 and the central mass of M1 and M2. Now say, M3 is even more than M1 plus M2. So we can state that the central mass of this system will be located somewhere on this line and will be closer to M3. So this we can call as central mass of system. So, you need to be very careful with this particular observational analysis. We can approximately locate the central mass of a system of any number of isolated particles. But exact calculation or exact location of central mass will be done in an analytical way. We'll study that also very soon. Now, let us talk about continuous object system. Continuous object system is a system of particle with all particles linked together to form an extended body. As we have just discussed, the discrete object system is the one in which there are two or more isolated or independent bodies are there and we locate central mass of the system. In continuous object system, here we talk about those particles which are linked together. When we talk about linked together, they'll produce extended body like we talk about a sphere. All particles of the sphere are attached to each other to form a solid body in shape of the sphere. As a sphere is symmetric, its central mass will be located at the center of this sphere or the geometric center. Similarly, say we are having a cube. In case of a cube also, we can see a cube is a geometrically symmetric object. So, its central mass will also be located exactly at its geometric center. So, we talk about a cone. In case of a cone, we can state, it is not a symmetric object. We talk about its altitude, its lower half will be containing larger masses and upper half is containing relatively lesser masses. Less number of particles are there. So, by observation, we can state the central mass will be located below the midpoint of its overall height. Say, if it is of height h by 2, then we can state that its central mass will be located at a height y, where y will be less than h by 2. Similarly, there can be many objects, like if we talk about a disk. In case of a disk, due to symmetry, its central mass will be located at the center of this disk. But say if we are having a semicircular disk or a half disk, in case of a half disk, we can state its central mass will be located at some height which is less than r by 2. We can write its height of central mass will be less than r by 2 because for the complete height of this semicircular disk, maximum mass is below the half height of this disk or maximum mass is located in the lower half region of the disk compared to the upper half. So center of mass will be located at a position which is below a height r by 2. Similarly, we are going to talk about mathematical analysis of calculation of center of mass about such kind of objects.